Un, dos, y un, dos, tres, y...
My name is Santos Ramos. I come from Puerto Rico. I'm 77 years old, and I've been in the United States since 1956. When I was working in the factory, I met a guy named Larry, and he introduced me to the weights. And since then, I've been married to the weights. And then when I started to decide not to work more, I came with the idea to open a gym. And everybody used to say, you're crazy. And May 26th, I opened for business, 1976. And everybody was laughing, and I'm glad I make it. I bleed this, I bleed for this. This is my life. Me, I come every day. I guess I miss like 2 weeks from the gym when I have my cervical operation. November 17, 1985, I guess I missed 2 weeks. And I wish I continue until the end of my time being here, share with the guys. I love my disciples a lot. Some of them deserve more than what I give them. I got about 100 people. They loyal to the place. They come and they treat me like a father. They see me like a father figure because some of them grow up without a father. They come here, they talk to me about things, and I give them good advice. I have been a bodybuilder for a long time, but mediocre bodybuilding. You know what I mean? Second-hand bodybuilding. I never had that big body, you know, but when I get in the stage, I enjoy myself. I dance, I do my things. I consider myself a crowd pleaser. Then I did the first WrestleMania. I was a referee there, and I was a thrill. I met all these people. Baby, let me tell you something. When I went into the ring and they announced myself, that was a thrill. That was something that I never gonna forget in my life. The guy in the wheelchair, it was my son. The love of my life. When my son died, July 22nd, 1985, I lost part of myself. He died from muscular dystrophy. Could you imagine a person like me who liked this game so much? Having a son that wasn't able to move. I used to carry him. I used to bring him on a wheelchair. I put the wheelchair down there. And I used to carry him up in my back up here and then go back for the chair. Because he spent some time with me here. That's it. There's not many places like this no more. Big corporations always swallow the small places. That's it. It's no doubt about it. You know, I don't know how long I'm going to be here, but I'm trying to keep it open. The neighborhood changed a lot. In the 60s, in the 70s, the neighborhood was bad. A lot of guns, a lot of drugs. Lately, since they opened the place across the street, It's getting hard, yes. Because remember, I pay everything. I pay phone, electricity, insurance, rent. I put my social security like for 2 years to cover my rent. Because I didn't want to close the place because I believe myself that I'm letting my people down. Sometimes I laugh because people say I buy this equipment from Flintstone. I got pieces in here that maybe 50 years old. I'm 77 years old, okay? If I retire, what I gonna do? Some people retire, so they don't do nothing. Few years later, goodbye Charlie Brown. No more Coca-Cola, finito, dead. Because they give up. I don't wanna give up yet. As long as I could come up, walk around, I'm gonna be around. I'm gonna be around like the Statue of Liberty for a long, long time. And I hope that someday this place make it big and I make it bigger to repay my members what they did for me. It's like a repayment for them. I consider this place the castle of iron, my castle, my home, my life. This is the place that I spend more time than at my own house, in my castle. And this is my chair. I consider myself the king. Excuse me. Good morning, Frenchies.